Folks, I've got news for you. Not only is inflation here, but it's much more rampant than the Fed will acknowledge. All of us have stories about a product that we're used to buying and it's increased by 100% and in many cases, 3x or more. And with semiconductors, lumber, raw materials, and warehousing costs all skyrocketing due to lack of supply, it's no wonder things like cars and electronics have gone up in price considerably. And what makes this current round of inflation exponentially worse is the fact that there is one thing that's increased in supply at an alarming rate, and that's the amount of newly printed money entering the economy. I'm going to talk about why housing is about to see another price jump pretty soon, and why this time I believe it's going to be in our North Jersey, Metro New York City area. Now, before we get started, I make all this content for free and I spend a lot of time researching all this information to make sure that I'm giving you as much detail as I can so you can make an accurate decision for yourself. So all I ask in return is that you hit that like button, subscribe, comment, and heck, if you want to know when these videos come out, as soon as they do, hit that notification button and you'll get notified. So let's get into the video. So let's start off with some of the terminology here and what the Fed is telling us. Push inflation is what they're telling us is taking place. And this is a scenario in which all of the additional costs of the inflated goods used to fabricate products and services are pushed onto the buyer. So the Fed has been calling this transitory inflation, suggesting that it's just temporary and it'll fade over time. And so this is where I agree and disagree at the same time, because I totally agree. Durable goods, or at least some durable goods like appliances, tools, cars, home furniture, will likely see supply chains come back over time. The American products are probably going to be back in business sooner. But since we're reliant on global supply chains, I think we're actually going to see this extend a lot longer than expected. You know, we have the FDA approved vaccines now, but people in manufacturing countries don't have access to them. You see where the problem lies? So that's just one inflationary issue that I think is being understated. But I feel like there's another one that's clear as day, and ultimately why I think we're going to see elevated levels of inflation for a longer time period. And that's wage inflation. And it's about to get wild. I mean, I can tell you personally, I know business owners in the restaurant and service industries, and they're having to offer 40 to 50% above the minimum wages, and they still can't fill all their positions. I mean, one of them I know is paying a worker $24 an hour to just spread cream cheese on the bagels. Come to think of it, I'm starting to want that job. And to add insult to injury, we're seeing gas prices increasing, making it more expensive to even travel to work. This was an organized shortage by OPEC, who voted to cut production in order to raise prices. And this has nothing to do with all of the other supply chain issues caused by coronavirus. So I'm done ranting about inflation. Now let's apply this to our local real estate market. As I stated a couple months ago, the rental market in New York City has already made a comeback. There's been bidding wars for quite some time now. We're seeing sales inventories drop on a weekly basis, partially because of the lower volume of sales listed at the end of summer, but also because of the rate of contracts picking up, which is more important. Businesses are now demanding that workers come back to work physically and not just remotely. And this is where the supply shock has occurred in the New York City rental market already. The Fed has stated that their quantitative easing in the form of low interest rates will continue, and that the tapering of purchasing of bonds and securities may be pushed back while the economy takes more time to recover. They have said they may move that forward. My opinion is that they're probably going to move that back. And in other words, that means more money printing. Inflation's already brought rental inventories back to pre-pandemic levels. This can be seen in an email I just received from StreetEasy displaying that the volume of rental visits on their website are up 52%. Viewership is up 63%, and rental contacts are up 79% year over year. Meanwhile, rental prices are soaring and interest rates continue to drop. We've seen the sale market pick up a bit, but not quite like some of the suburbs and other areas of the country that they've seen the past 12 months. So this leads me to believe that the Hudson County market is primed to take off here in the next 30 to 45 days. We're talking higher levels of showings, multiple offers, and higher prices. So as a buyer or seller, it's important that you evaluate the direction of the market. You don't want to sell yourself short as a homeowner or miss a buying opportunity as a buyer only to have to increase your budget on the next property that you see. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and please pass along this information to anyone that you feel may benefit. As always, feel free to call, text, or email if you have any questions or would like to set up a strategy session. As always, thank you again, and I hope to talk to you soon.